All right, guys, this must be Quick Tip Saturday because I got a bunch of quick tips for you. Customer had me pick up an HS720 Honda, which is a single stage thrower, but it's a four stroke. Doesn't take any oil, works off a four stroke. This is a nice model, expensive, probably about 800 bucks, brand new. It's got electric start, it's got regular start, fuel valve on off, shoot rotator, all that stuff. It's a really nice thrower. Well, the customer kept fueling it for the year, forgot about it. Went to go start it this year, and of course, you know, with ethanol fuel, ain't gonna start. So brought it home, I said, okay, let me drain out the fuel. So I cleaned out the gas tank, and I ended up taking all these covers off so I could get to the carburetor. Then I thought to myself, wait a minute, there's gotta be a better way. Why would you have to take off all the covers and all that? Well, I used to take off all the covers on all my Honda blowers and Toro blowers. It was just easier to get to everything, you know? But really what you need to do, if you want to drain the fuel out, you see that hole right there? That's an access hole. And it's an access hole to get to the carburetor inside. Let me see if I can go in there. Can you see in there? Hey, there you go. See that screw right there? That little silver screw? That's the drain screw. And that drain screw opens a valve in there so that a pink hose, I don't know if you can see under there, there's a pink hose that comes out the bottom. Oh, where am I? There's a pink hose that comes out the bottom. I don't know if I can get a good picture of it in there somewhere. Somewhere in there. Hard to see, but anyway, there's a pink hose that comes out the bottom of the carburetor, which is the drain, okay? And if you go in with a long screwdriver and you unscrew that counterclockwise, that little silver screw in the float bowl, maybe a turn or two, you'll see fuel start spitting out of that little pink hose. It's gonna get all over here on the engine, okay? Don't get me wrong, it's gonna get all over, so put a bowl underneath or something. But that's the drain. And you could drain the whole fuel tank there. It's going to take a while because it's a very small hose. But instead of taking off all these screws and take the chute off. I mean, I made the mistake where I went online real quick and just said, hey, let me cheat a little bit. I'll go on YouTube and I'll see how someone got one of these things running. He's taking all the covers off and everything. And I was like, do I really have to do that? Well, the answer is no. You go in that little cheater hole in there, right there, with a flat screwdriver. You unscrew it a turn or two, all the fuel will drain out. Let it drain out, wipe out the inside of your fuel tank with a rag. I use a hemostat and a rag. Wipe out the whole inside of the gas tank. Let me show you my favorite tool in the whole world, which is a surgical hemostat. Love these things. You could use them to pull fuel line, you can use them to put a rag on the end, you can swish it around your gas tank. That's what I use it for a lot. I'll use it to get into the gas tank. And since this hemostat that I have is pretty long, it's about 16 inches, well, 12, 14 inches, I'll put a rag on the end and I'll shove it in the gas tank and I'll swish all around left and right. It's the rag stays attached because the hemostat locks, got a lock on it. And that way you can clean out the fuel tank, get all the water out of it, whatever else is in there. Then it's a nice sunny day today. Put it in the driveway for 10 minutes, let the sun beat on it, let it get nice and clean. Once the fuel tank's nice and clean, you've already drained out the carburetor. Well, then I'll put some fresh fuel in. I'll keep that carb drain open because if there's anything left in the line, water or anything, I want to push it out. So put the fresh fuel in there, let it drain for about 10 seconds. Shut off the fuel valve so there's no more fuel coming out. Shut off the bowl drain, fill it with fuel, try it out. It works fine. That's all I did to this thing. Cleaned it out nice and easy, but I took the covers off and did it the hard way because I didn't know about the cheater hole. So it doesn't say it in the manual anywhere. I didn't see it anyway in the manual. I did look at it. So just so you know. And another thing on these blowers, some people have asked me about them and I figured something out here. You got the chute up and down right here. It makes the chute go up and down. Look at the size of that spring on there, okay? Now, I'm a pretty strong guy. You know, I'm over 6 feet, over 250. I'm a big, strong guy. Well, I took this lever, I'm like, my God, that is so hard to push. Look at the chute. You gotta push really hard. See that? I'm pushing hard here, and I'm a strong guy. Well, it's because that spring is so darn hard and so darn tight, I took the spring off, the thing worked like butter, okay? So, you know, if someone who buys this thing is a little old lady and she's having trouble with it, instead of breaking her wrist trying to push that, you know, get a shorter spring or get a, you know, a weaker spring, you know, so it's a lot easier. I don't know how the lady who has this thing uses it, but man, I had to use all my muscle to get that thing to go forward. Anyway, that's the tips on these HS720s. So any questions, put it in the comments, but you got the cheater hole on the side where you can drain all the fuel. That's easy. You got this heavy spring you got to overcome when you're using the flapper up and down for the chute. You know, other than that, drain the gas out. That's why that valve is there. At the end of the season, drain it out. And you know what? If you're not using too much fuel during the year, buy the non-ethanol fuel. Not good for me because I won't see you the following season, but good for you because you'll get a nice running snow blower that you can even keep the fuel in all year without the ethanol. It's not going to attract water and it should last. So, all right, guys, I rambled on long enough. That's it. Any questions? Give me a shout there. Comment, like, subscribe, everything. I appreciate all you guys for visiting. We'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.